In the aldol reaction, an enolate reacts with an aldehyde or a ketone to give initially beta-hydroxycarbonyl compound. So that's the product of the aldol reaction, a beta-hydroxycarbonyl compound. But under catalytic conditions, that beta-hydroxycarbonyl compound will not be the final product. That's because the beta-hydroxycarbonyl compound undergoes elimination reaction to give the alpha-beta unsaturated carbonyl compound. Let's draw the structure of acetaldehyde in order to illustrate the traditional aldol reaction again. So this is acetaldehyde. That's acetaldehyde. If acetaldehyde is treated with catalytic amount of an ethoxide ion, say ethoxide ion, would deprotonate at that position, the alpha position of acetaldehyde. So we can show that. So the ethoxide ion would take off that proton to form the corresponding enolate, which is this one here. So this is the enolate, and the enolate then reacts with acetaldehyde itself in this condensation reaction. So we can show, we can draw the structure of acetaldehyde again. So that's it. That's the structure of acetaldehyde. The enolate does nucleophilic addition on acetaldehyde. So this is the product that is obtained. Beta alkoxy. Beta alkoxy aldehyde. Of course, as a result of this initial deprotonation step, there is ethanol. Catalytic amount of it again, because remember, catalytic amount of ethoxide is actually used. So, for example, 1 mole of acetaldehyde, 0.01 mole of the ethoxide to give 0.01 mole of the enolate, which will then react with 0.01 mole of an unreacted aldehyde to give also not only the beta alkoxy aldehyde, but also ethanol, which would then act as a proton source in the, under these conditions. So the alkoxide picks up a proton from ethanol to give beta hydroxy aldehyde. So this is beta hydroxy aldehyde plus the ethoxide ion, of course, regenerated, and thus it can be reused or recycled, and thus the description of catalytic, if you like, or a catalyst. A catalyst, of course, is never consumed. Okay, it's always used and reused, used and reused and recycled. So the beta hydroxycarbon aldehyde in this case is actually formed. Now, this product will undergo after formation, its formation will undergo elimination reaction to give finally the alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound or aldehyde in this case, under these conditions, the catalytic base conditions. So what can the catalytic base do? So there is still the ethoxide ion. That's the ethoxide ion. Now the ethoxide ion will continue to act as a base. So it will remove, and it does remove a hydrogen at the alpha position. So like this, so proton abstraction to give the corresponding, again, the corresponding enolate. So this is the enolate that is formed. This is the enolate that's formed as a result of this deprotonation step. Now this enolate will be the driving force behind the departure of that poor leaving group, which is the hydroxyl group. So the enolate, if you like, kicks that OH to make basically a double bond between the alpha carbon and the beta carbon. So the carbonyl compound reforms like that. So a double bond between oxygen and carbon is reformed. The carbon-carbon double bond is broken, and a carbon-carbon double bond is formed here with the departure of this poor leaving group to give this final product, or final alpha beta, actually alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound, where there is a double bond between the alpha and beta carbon. It's alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound that is the product after this elimination reaction. Of course, this elimination reaction is very very unique. It's called E1CB. So this is E1CB type elimination reaction, where E1 type or elimination reaction takes place on the conjugate base. And of course, this is the conjugate base of that aldehyde, because that aldehyde acted as an acid. So that's the acid, this is the conjugate base, and the E1 type elimination, or the first order kinetic elimination reaction, takes place on the conjugate base to give the alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound. So under catalytic base conditions, or in alpha condensation reactions, the final product is actually an alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound. Initially, yes, beta hydroxycarbonyl compound is formed, but with catalytic base, that catalytic base will affect elimination of the hydroxyl group to give alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound. So in summary, carbonyl compounds with an alpha hydrogen, if they are treated with catalytic base, an alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound is formed.